We'll cover how to run a hypothesis test and construct a confidence interval for a difference of two means using a Casio fx-9750 graphing calculator in the context of an example. If you haven't already watched the one sample inference video for this Casio calculator, please do so. Do embryonic stem cells help improve heart function following a heart attack? We'll consider an experiment where 18 sheep had heart attacks and were randomized into treatment and control groups. Sheep in the treatment group received embryonic stem cell treatment, while sheep in the control group received no special treatment. The heart pumping function of the sheep's hearts were measured before and after the experiment, and we'll analyze the relative changes in heart pumping function shown here. We want to evaluate whether embryonic stem cells had an influence on the change in heart pumping function of sheep that had suffered a heart attack. We'll first write down the hypotheses. We'll use a one-sided test and a significance level of 0.05. To conduct the hypothesis test, navigate to the stats section. Since we don't have summary data, we'll need to enter the raw data into lists. Here, I'll enter the control data into the first list and the treatment data into the second list. With the data entered, I'll go to test for hypothesis test, and then T for t-test, and I'll choose 2s for two samples of numerical data. I start by indicating that I'll use lists for the data in the test. Next, I specify the sidedness of the hypotheses. I'll think of mu1 as representing the control group and mu2 as representing the treatment group, so I'll choose less than. Next, I need to specify the lists. The correct lists are already shown here. The frequency values are for if we have tabulated data. Usually that's not the case, so a value of 1 is appropriate. Finally, I choose whether I want to pool the data or not for the standard deviation. It's most common to not make the assumption that the standard deviations are equal, and so to not pool the standard deviation calculation. It's important that I've specified the proper lists for the proper groups, especially when doing a one-sided test. Recall that I entered the control data in list 1, and mu1 would represent the true average for no special treatment. The treatment group uses list 2 and mu2. Always keep your data organized to avoid silly mistakes, and always sanity check your work. I can hit execute to get the test results. First up is a summary of the alternative hypothesis, then the test statistic, the p-value of 8.4E-04, which we can write as 0.00084, and the degrees of freedom for the test statistic. Because the p-value is so small, we reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the embryonic stem cells causes an improvement in the heart pumping function for sheep that have had a heart attack relative to sheep that receive no special treatment. Now that I've completed the hypothesis test, I can exit out to the main stat page. Since there was a statistically significant difference, it makes me wonder, how big was that difference? I'd like to answer that question with a confidence interval. I'll again use the data from the lists, and I'll navigate to inter for confidence interval. I want to construct a t-interval, and I want to do so in a two-sample setting. First, I specify whether to use lists of data or summary information. Then I choose the confidence level, and finally, I specify the data. Here again, we have the option of whether to pool or not. The values already provided in the calculator already match what I want, so I can go ahead and hit execute to get the confidence interval. The left end of the interval is a negative 11.3, and the right end is negative 4.4. However, something seems weird. This interval is entirely below zero, but we observed an increase in heart pumping function in the treatment group. Our interval is the reverse effect. To get the proper interval, we can take the negative of the interval endpoints and reverse the endpoints to get the confidence interval of interest. We are 90% confident that embryonic stem cells increase heart pumping function of sheep that have had a heart attack by 4.4 to 11.3% relative to no special treatment. Notice that this interval is entirely above zero, so it's consistent with the conclusion from our hypothesis test. One last quick note. In the rare case where the standard deviation for both populations is known and not estimated using our samples, that is, we know sigma for each of the populations, we would want to choose a z-confidence interval or a z-test instead of a t-confidence interval or a t-test. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to our channel.